Well, fortunately for the people in this country, he doesn't live or die by the polls, just the same way for Jeb. He'd been up and he'd been down, and but that's not what you're elected to do. You're elected to govern, not be hold your finger in the wind and see which way the wind's blowing. I'm very proud of the president. He's come under great fire. He takes principled positions for what's in his heart, what he believes to be right, and he doesn't take an opinion poll before he goes forth and takes his case to the people. He wins some, he loses some. But I'll tell you, I haven't seen the latest figures and all, but I guarantee it doesn't bother him. We talk to him a lot, not about, hey, Dad, what do I do now, that kind of stuff, or but, you know, an awful lot, just as we would with Jeb, a father and a son, a mother and a son talking. And I never get the feeling that it gets him down. I never get the feeling that the pummeling he takes in some predictable outlets of the American press, for example, or in Congress, get him down. He just goes about his business. So it's not an easy time, but he's strong. We talk quite a bit by telephone calls early in the morning, you know. And again, I have every reason to be a very proud dad.
Mr. President, it's nice having you in Naples today. If I could stray real fast here, what do you make of the feeling between the president right now and a lot of the Republicans now that the Dubai company has pulled out of the American port deal?
You've asked the right guy. You've asked the expert on what it feels when your party people turn against you. And look, these things come and go. I happen to think he was 100% correct in his assessment of the national interest, including the security interests of the United States. But that deal got for him a lot of bad feeling from some of his own people. But again, we're grown-ups in the family, and we know how to take it as well as dish it out. So you expect it, and when your friends, you know, find it difficult to support what you want, that makes it doubly hard. But it doesn't, I think the point I was trying to make, it doesn't get him down. And I haven't talked to him in the last 48 hours, but it's tough when your party turns on you. On the other hand, when I was president, not particularly interested in that here, but I had the opposition party control both houses of the Congress for the 4 years I was president. So if George thinks he's got a problem, he ought to try what I had on for size. You see how lucky he is.
That in mind, who's your pick right now? Who are you seeing right now progressing as the...
Mr. Jeb.
Okay.
Who do you think is going to be next president?
No.
Governor? Yeah.
It's too early. It really is too early.
You mentioned George is no child left behind since we're talking about literacy and education.
Why don't you do it, Mom?
Well, I think he's done a great job on that. He's made education...
Take your case right here.
I will. But he's made education accountable. People get mad because you're tested. Well, I think that's wrong. How are we going to know how we're doing? And they're doing a good job, and they've worked very, very hard. And I don't dare look at Jeb and see if he approves of No Child Left Behind, but you do, and I do, too.
He did it before he stole it from us.
Oh, he stole it from Jeb.
George.
No. Oh, Jeb, George stole it from Jeb.
Yeah.
That reminds me of the time they asked Jeb, why are you running for office? And he said, three reasons, George, Noel, and Jebby. And a week later, they asked George why he was running, and he said, well, I'm running because of Jenna and Barbara. They said, well, your brother said that. And he said, yes, if he says anything else smart, I'm going to copy that, too.
Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, man.
Very good question.
Hey, you think he'd go live with us on TV? It'd be an award. It'd be an award winner. Who can grab him? I'm hooked up.
Good to be here.
Still around, we'll walk over, and if it happens, I'll call back.